morning turned into afternoon and has now turned into evening. A very warm welcome to the Antrim Forum in Northern Ireland. It's the last match of the day in the Netball Europe Open Championships, and we're bringing this to you live and exclusive by QTV Sports and Stream UK. I'm Alison Mitchell, and we have already had a thrilling day of action, but we've arguably saved the best for you until last as England take on South Africa, the top two sides ranked in this Netball Europe Open competition. And South Africa being outside of Europe, this is a match which doesn't go towards the official title of European champions, but it is an official ranking fixture. And with the World Cup build-up, these matches are all important as coaches look to finalise their squads of 12 ahead of Sydney, which is fast approaching in August. Well, with me is Lynn Carpenter, former England international, now chair of Netball Europe, and this is going to be quite a brilliant matchup and the biggest test. Both these teams have played already today, but this is the biggest test.
I think so, Alison. It's going to be highly competitive. Both teams are trying out new combinations. We saw that earlier with England Netball. South Africa have some new faces in this squad. Some of their more regular players couldn't make this trip, so great opportunities for them. There is no doubt this is going to be really competitive, and they both want to win the open competition outright.
Let's take you through the teams then for England and South Africa. And there are some changes made to the starting sevens that took to the court earlier in the day. England beat Trinidad and Tobago earlier, 63-42. And they make, only three players are the same as that first match this morning. McLoma starts at goalkeeper, Francis back in at goal defence, Malcolm at wing defence, she played earlier, Sarah Bayman at centre, Tamsin Greenway at wing attack, Pam Cookie starts at goal attack, and Helen Housby as goal shooter. So that team looking much more similar to those which played in the test series against Trinidad and Tobago. As for South Africa, Adele Niemant is at goalkeeper, Rochelle Lawson goal defence, Precious Mtembu at wing defence, Erin Berger is centre, Izette Lube wing attack, Marika Holtzhaus in goal attack, and Potgieter is goal shooter. As we are underway in South Africa, making just the one change to the side that beat Scotland earlier with Luba on at wing attack, and Helsby has been floored immediately, but we'll have the penalty parcel shot now to get England's match underway and get them on the scoreboard. And she does. South Africa's centre, Erin Berger. And for the two coaches, and Tracy Neville in particular, she did make a lot of changes and saw a lot of players in that first match of the day.
Yeah, and this combination's gone out and turned over South Africa's centre pass first time. Some really good tight man-on-man defence there for Sierra. And there's a lot at stake in this competition here for England this weekend. All these players are fighting for a place in that final 12 to get on the plane for Sydney in August.
Lead Housby making it 2-0. And Housby of Manchester Thunder. Good height in the circle. And we're working at the moment with Pam Cookie, the England captain and player who, well, this is her 104th cap. Pam Cookie. Super form during the Super League season. Yeah, a bit of a tumble for Berger early on, with contact against Sarah Bayman.
The player's just finding the way in the first few minutes of the game. Some competitiveness going on in there, but good defence by England Netball, and Cloma bringing it out.
And that was the tumble of Berger. Bayman, I don't think, was terribly impressed with the call.
Just an unforced error there by England Netball. Just need to settle down.
Lynn, this is the second match in the day for both teams. I mean, how often would they play two matches in one day competitively like this? As Cookie gets a chance on goal now.
Which she'll score and put away. It's quite unusual, to be honest. It's the way the tournament's worked in terms of wanting to have all the teams here that we have, and obviously limited space in a venue of this nature. We only have the one court, so they won't necessarily be used to playing at this level. But international netball in the sort of top 12 in the world is all about fitness, mental agility, and the ability to keep going at that standard. And I expect the coach, Tracy Neville, will be looking at how her players cope under this pressure, as no doubt the South African coach will too. There's a number of new faces in this side for South Africa, some young players in particular. So it'll be interesting to see how they manage to last out after they've all been on court for a full 2 hours by the end of the game.
Yeah, both squads in the same boat, at least in terms of their court time. High ball in as they look to get into the circle. It's a good reach by Potgieter.
South Africa just a little bit hesitant about feeding the shooters at the moment. Not quite sure what Francis McCloma are going to do, but good feed from that occasion.
Potgieter with a shot here for South Africa. Makes it 4-2. Cookie's looking for options. Bayman is there and supports. Well into Cookie. That's goal defence called for contact.
I think England have really been working on lots of different combinations. And you can see another set of seven out there on the court today. And looking at the different offers that the players can bring. So, you know, are they a one position player or can they offer more? I guess that'll all be part of the coaching team's decision as they think about a few weeks' time.
Yeah, we might well see, I'm sure, some changes as we go through the quarter intervals. Perhaps Tracy Neville trying a player in a different position to see how well they cope.
Yeah, I think it's a good opportunity to look at players. If you're not going to try them something like this, when will you see them? And all these games count. These are all ranking games, so I'm expecting both coaches to want to come out and win this match.
Yeah, you
no
can't
doubt
be too
about
experimental,
that.
Can you?
No.
You're still wanting to put out what you believe is your strongest team that will help you win the match, whilst at the same time having a look with that World Cup in mind. So a bit of a balancing act being done by the coaches. Stacey Francis, then, who's overcome injury, but then an intercept by Berger, has got South Africa back in the action. Just wayward at the end. But Francis was out since March of this year with a knee injury.
She'll be disappointed now. That's two turnovers in the space of a couple of passes from her.
McCloma is often so vocal from the back of the court. Really communicates well in that goal third. Bayman finds Housby.
The Cookie-Housby combination is really effective out there. Strong rotation in the circle. Housby's not afraid to move and create space for Cookie. South Africa is struggling at the moment to close down that effective attack by England.
Malcolm with a long pass to Bayman, and Cookie making a good drive into the circle, seeing that gap.
Yep. Very good start by England so far.
Tamsin Greenway herself will be eager to prove to Tracy Neville that she's worth a spot on the plane to Australia. Housby, neat work from the tall, lithe shooter. 6 foot tall she stands, Helen Housby, just 20 years of age. Well, she's left unmarked. And simple under the post.
Yeah, good vision by the South Africans then making that spot. McCloma came out for the interception, didn't quite time it right.
There's Housby. Well, you've got that quartet of two Manchester Thunder and two Surrey Storm players around that England circle with Greenway and Cookie.
Yeah, clearly a very competitive end to the Super League season for England netball. And these players not so long ago were playing against each other, yet seamlessly they've moved into their national side and playing very well in terms of the various combinations.
In that attacking third as well, Bayman at centre and Housby, both Manchester Thunder, his Greenway. Contact against the South African goalkeeper. So Housby will have a go, the long shot from there. Yep.
She doesn't miss many.
Very accurate, Helen Housby. Francis, long ball down the sideline.
That's a great take by Pamela Cookie there. Good ball into the circle from Housby.
Fantastic.
South Africa will be disappointed with their start here. That was better. Creating space.
Yeah, well, England have really been able to run away with an early lead. They'll be delighted with this start. Greenway looking for Housby. Looking for the 1-2, but well, Cookie drives into the circle. Missed out that time, but
yeah, called for using the post to balance by the umpire.
Precious Ntembe with the free pass. Finds the centre, Erin Berger. Well, I think it's almost taken the goal shooter by surprise then. That was a nice little thing.
She took all of us by surprise then. I wasn't quite sure where the ball was going.
That was lovely shot.
Yeah, great shot. Distance from Francis looked pretty close to the 3 foot if it wasn't quite there. Good lean on her.
Yeah, she's in a good position for that overhead. Quite a battle for any goal shooter who's up against the 6 foot frame of Sonia McComa. Bayman then, as Malcolm comes in to support. Housby,
great
nice
change of direction there. Take the ball under the post.
It all looks very smooth from England at the moment. They're moving that ball down into the goal third. Housby is shooting accurately. Cookie's making lots of decisive runs into the circles.
I think we thought that South Africa would perhaps come out a little bit stronger, particularly in light of the performance earlier on today. Perhaps it just shows the quality of this England side.
Yeah, it is a step up in qualities. Cookie shoots for goal again. And in the past, I mean, England have been multiple eight times winners of this championship, but they haven't always sent their strongest team here. With the World Cup now approaching, it's a great time for England to be involved, but I'm sure lots of people would like them to be here in strength in future years as well.
Absolutely, it's that dilemma about getting the competition right for everybody, and it doesn't do any teams any favours if they get beaten by significant amounts. Good passage of play there. But likewise, England can't always take it for granted that sending an under 21 team will beat the likes of the other UK member countries now. They're
Which
all
they
ranked in the top 12.
In 2013, Wales.
That's right. Wales won that
England.
Championship hosted up in Aberdeen by Netball Scotland, and Wales came along away winners.
Well, that's where having the likes of South Africa, Trinidad, and his invitational side just raises the bar and provides the likes of England with stiffer competition.
Yeah, and of course, Wales, Scotland and Northern Ireland are going to benefit from playing against them as well. They're very different style to what we see in the region. And I think that's how you really go to a World Cup and perform, when you've actually had an opportunity to test yourselves against a different style.
Good defensive work from Malcolm. Gets the turnover.
Need to watch those hands. The South Africans were doing the same this morning. They've got very good reach and they were getting quite a lot of hands to the ball, some good turnovers.
Great leap from Cookie into the circle. does that so often, catches the ball mid-air, times her jump to perfection so then she can land much closer to the post.
Bit of a slight misunderstanding there between Bayman and Greenway. Gave the ball back to South Africa.
And it's Mtembu then with the free pass. A bit of a tussle going on there between the two centres. Bayman comes off the better. A little bit of a fumble. I think Malcolm lost completely where the ball was for a moment. Bayman, the Housby. Contact on the, from the goalkeeper. This should be a simple put away from Helen Housby. Mtembu into Holtzhausen.
McClellan pulled there for feeling her player on the edge of the circle.
Holtzhausen will take the penalty parcel shot.
Yep. Can't argue with that.
Bayman straight to Greenway off that centre pass. Housby has got space. And Greenway feed it in again. Cookies.
England are creating a lot of two offer options on the court, which is impressive. So means if one player is going, they, when looking forward, they've actually got more than one choice at one time. So their speed of recognising when they need to go in terms of the combinations on the court is really positive.
Oh, nice work from Francis to take the rebound and keep it in play.
Transition from defence to attack.
They're really
very
swift
fast
by England here. Well, that was a good tip over by the South African centre, but they win possession anyway. Holtzhausen, long high ball, but McClomer is, oh, she's there and she's sticking to her player. That's the end of the first quarter. And well, it has been England's, that is for sure. And they lead over South Africa after the first 15 minutes. 18 points to 9, so opening up a 9-goal gap, which will make them feel quite comfortable, Lynn Carpenter, as they head off to the benches to get their drinks and have a good talking to from Tracy Neville as well.
It'll be interesting to hear what Tracy, the coach of England Netball, is saying at the moment. Cause it looks good when you look at the score, but I would guess there's going to be aspects of the play that Tracy wouldn't have been completely happy with. And I think, in fact, they could have probably been further ahead to England Netball on that occasion.
We might be able to listen in to Tracy, so let's see what she says.
On the attack, yeah. In these positions,
it's not terribly clear to hear what Tracy Neville is saying there, but certainly focusing her instructions there on the midcourt with Tamsin Greenway as wing attack. And wing defence as well, and Laura Malcolm.
It's interesting, Malcolm went from smiling then when Tracy came over. Looked just a little bit more serious then. I think Malcolm had a good start. Tracy might be just talking about her ball handling skills a little bit. There was a couple of fumbles in there.
Well, this is some of the South African shooting. And from the England side of things as well. And Helen Housby, I mean, what a thrill it is for her to be playing with Pamela Cook in the circle for England, because she was saying during that the TNT series how she'd idolised Pamela Cookie from when she was a little girl, and now here she is with an England dress on
playing
in the goal circle with her.
On equal terms, I would
Absolutely.
Suggest. You look at the two and you wouldn't necessarily think that Housby is somebody who's just come into the international scene. And we have to remember, she hasn't played that many internationals. She had a, you know, the end of the season, 12 months or so ago, that shot for Thunder that got them the game. Another Super League season under her belt, and then we are here. So she's still relatively new, but playing really well.
And able to hold her own in the same team with the likes of Sonia McClomer, who captain England with aplomb and back in the side after her last appearance in 2011. She's been over in Australia, plays her club netball over there, but over 100 caps to her name, and McLemore made her debut back in 1999.
I remember it well, Alison.
So South Africa have some work to do then, coming back out on court trailing by 9 after the first quarter against England. I mentioned they had that win over Scotland earlier in the day. England beat Trinidad, made it 4 wins out of 4 over their Trinidadian opponents after the test series. And now England ranked 3rd in the world, leading by 9 against South Africa, who are ranked 6th in the world. Both teams looking forward to the World Cup. So the question is, who will make those squads? And that is a large part of what these players are playing for throughout this tournament. So England underway straight away. Bayman finding Housby. Greenway asking for it on the edge of the circle. Little fumble from Cookie. Rare fumble. Housby's free. Good running.
And that rotation where
the circle.
Cookie pulls out and the Housby's filling the space and creating an option immediately in the front of the circle to make it easy for the feeds.
Berger.
England are doing a good defensive job by pushing, forcing South Africa wide there.
Holtzhausen, great work from her, keeping her cool. Played for Loughborough Lightning, of course, in the Super League. So, Bayman, Greenway, Cookie. Gotta feed it into that circle. Bayman's looking for options and having to go back. Housby's there. Cookie getting herself into position. A little bit of contact going on against Cookie. Penalty pass for shot then. It's in a comfortable zone for Cookie. 10 goals the difference. Holtzhausen having to go long across the D, and again, can't get that penetration through, but they do now.
It's not easy for the South African wing attack and centre to find the shooters in there at the moment. They're getting pulled wide and deep and not giving that many options. Yep.
Stacey Francis, one of those who's been doing good work in the circle with McLoma. Bayman. Good interception, Michelle Lawson. Preventing Cookie from getting the ball. Got a throw in. Greenway does well to keep the ball in play. Yeah, that one's gone England's way. Lovely work from Housby. She looks like she is built for goal shooting. Those long arms, able to hold the ball and carry it so high above her head. Just extending the natural height she has.
She is. She's got great reach, great elevation. You know, she's able to split land really well, so she's got good reach with her legs. But it's her mobility, I think, that's just main more impressive than anything.
Laura Malcolm will have the free pass.
Great work by Cookie. Cutting the circle, making a really good option.
And they've widened the gap to 11 with this opportunity now for Housby.
Yeah, it was a real confident take there of what was a challenging ball coming in, but she did really well on it.
Well, Stacey Francis in some tough contention there. So two players in the circle for McLoma to mark, makes it a pretty impossible job. Francis back in play again though.
South Africa made it a little bit easy by not having both of the players available in there. McLoma did really well.
Holtzhaus moved out of the circle, didn't she? Here's Potgieter. Quick movement again by England to get that ball down to the circle. I'm putting these goals away pretty rapidly at the moment, are England?
They're making it look easy, but of course at this level nothing is easy. but it's their timing, I think, in particular, that's creating some of the options in the circle. And their awareness of where each other are going to be, particularly Cookie and Housby. That was a rare miss shot by Housby.
Doesn't miss much today. You see Frances there pointing to Holzhauser. She knew she was heading into the circle, but as it is, Potgieter who will have the attempt on goal. Oh, I don't think that'll please the coach. Adele Niemantz, who was a player of the match, the goalkeeper was, when South Africa beat England in 2013, a little while ago now.
I think it's 18 months, so not a huge amount of time in the netball cycle, but...
I suppose with the amount that the international netball is played, yes.
Look at the score now, it's certainly showing England much more competitive. Yeah. And that was that switching in the circle. Housby came out, gave an option, but Bayman also had the option of Cookie going under the post. Really good understanding between those three. Bit of a fumble there.
I mean, it's one of the challenges of, in England have players from the ANZ who come back and are in World Cup contention as well. Will these players be at an advantage for the fact that they have played in combinations together in competitive matches like this?
Well, when we talked about this a number of years ago in England netball, one of the aims was clearly to have our players playing the best competition that they could in terms of the players in the Northern Hemisphere here. And for those players who have been successful in the ANZ, it's a risk, let's be honest about it. Super League now is highly competitive. There's players from all over the world want to come and play in it. And they're getting that good, tight, competitive matches week in, week out, which is what makes effective teams. So there was always a risk that at some point, these players who are here and playing regularly might just have an advantage over the ANZ ones. It will be competitive. It will be a tough choice for the coach, Tracy Neville.
And those who are playing in ANZ, as South Africa pull one back, bring a certain amount of knowledge with them of players from Australia and New Zealand who they will come up against in the World Cup. So there's that added knowledge that they give, as well as they will have honed their skills and you know, built strong reputations for themselves in their own right in that competition.
And let's not forget, some of the players from England who've gone down to the ANZ have done extremely well. Been named players of the year, Joe Harton's been that, Ebony's Beckford Chambers, Sonia,
Jay Clark. Great reputation at tactics. Really has excelled at centre.
Absolutely. When you look at some of the depth that England netball now has, it's great to have the choice. And that can only be good for the sport, for them, but also for the region in driving up standards as well.
Here's Housby then, who plays her netball for Manchester Thunder. And Cookie, who's Super League champion with Surrey Storm. And the Super League really has developed into such a highly competitive, well-followed, well-supported competition. Greenwell have the free throw, edge of the circle. Cookie's desperate for it. This should put England 26-14 ahead. It certainly does.
Well read there by McCloma, but I think the umpire spotted a contact by Bayman.
Yeah, eagle-eyed, these umpires.
Yeah, the umpire downed. The England end is actually an Australian umpire. Although she's living and working in England at the moment.
Oh, good hassle from Frances. Well, that was a terrific long-range effort.
Oh, unlucky.
But nope, the whistle's already gone. I think the ball out of play.
Yeah, umpire spotted that. Her foot was over the line, so it won't count.
Cookie Greenway. Housby again finding good space. looked for a moment if she might have taken the shot on goal. Cookie's in a better position now, though. Took a hand to the face. No, not content to shoot.
Well, she had quite a challenge there, and that's just sometimes it throws you off balance. And I can hear characteristic of her not to shoot.
I can hear Tracy Neville sitting there on the England bench, very vocal.
If you have goal attack, go shooter on you, babe. You've got to shoot.
Yep. It'd be interesting to we should follow Tracy Neville at the next quarter break, see if she speaks to Pam Cookie. Plenty of communication going out on the court, plenty of calling and shouting.
That's one of the strengths that McClymer brings to the side, that natural leadership on and off the court.
And when you're playing goalkeeper, you have a view of the passages of play the whole time.
Absolutely.
Don't you? You have the best view, arguably, of anybody else on the team.
And some of the best partnerships in defence are the ones who can really work together and talk to each other and call each other.
Cookie wasn't going to think twice about shooting that time. Greenway then, Cookie. Greenway again, Housby struggling to get free, and although Cookie's opponent's flawed, she will get. No, she's going to have to shoot again.
There was two balls stray on the ball. Court.
Stray ball rolled onto the court.
Not quite sure whether the umpire didn't call the first shot going in. Perhaps thought it was after he spotted the ball. Not sure.
Umpire is always doing well, spotting incidents off the ball. Yeah, obstruction called again. The South African defence is struggling to contain.
Yeah, I think they just need a little bit of discipline in there. They're giving away quite a lot of penalties. I think they're probably being outplayed somewhat by Cookie and Housby, and that can get a little bit frustrating. But they do need a little bit more discipline.
Long ball down to Holthausen. Some powerful driving from South Africa, but they keep possession. Holthausen. Well, she's able to get room then as Francis moved in towards the post.
Good defence as England are forcing South African shooters to go.
They've got to go out before they come back in, haven't they?
Oh, good pressure by Malcolm.
Cookie's looking for her options. Greenway has Malcolm in support if she needs, but finds Bayman. Oh, good take from Cookie. Again, seeing the space.
Yep,
a
great
clear
rotation.
Indication of where she wanted the ball.
And what I like about Cookie is when she cuts the post, she cuts so effectively that she gets into really good, strong shooting positions all the time. There you go. Almost identical.
It almost induces the contact from the goal defence, because the only way she can try and get to the ball is by infringing.
Her positioning is really good, and her body management is effective.
Clemmer doing her best to try and keep Kotgita out of the... Oh, McClymer is questioning, I think, whether she got close. She was so careful. She looked like she was being so careful.
I think she didn't get called for 3 feet. It was for face over the player's
eyes.
Yeah. That appeared to be what it was. We're not seeing a huge amount of Greenway wing attack in this quarter. Good rebound by Hasby.
Greenway's not making herself available quite enough, struggling to get free. Is it more the combination of the Cookie, Bayman, Housby trio working?
I think the wing defence is being effective. Um, I think perhaps it's just the movement and where she's choosing to go. Quite frequently she's being forced to feed from quite far out rather than the circle edge.
We see her a lot with Rachel Dunn, don't we? Very close to each other.
Yeah,
reading
it's
each
quite
other
unusual
very well in that
to see her playing that style of wing attack. Maybe that's what the coach has asked her to do.
Well, it could well be. And though Tracy Neville has tried to become very clear in her instructions with what she wants her players to do, I think in that first match against Trinidad, yeah, there were times when I think players felt they maybe weren't altogether clear, and Tracy acknowledged that she needed to perhaps issue instructions clearer. And we're approaching half-time here. Halsby will have a chance before the timer runs out. Oh, hefty margins now built up. And that is the whistle for half-time. And England have extended that lead really quite comfortably. An 18-goal margin at this stage. That is a hefty deficit for South Africa to make up now, Lynn Carpenter.
It is. It's a 9-goal lead in both quarters, so very consistent from England in terms of that performance. Disappointing from South Africa. I did think they'd be more competitive, certainly at least in the first quarter. But to be nearly 20 goals down when you're ranked 6th in the world against the 3rd-ranked is perhaps not quite what we expected, although we know that South Africa don't have their strongest 12 here, and we're likely to see a different looking team when they actually get to Sydney in August.
Yeah, I think there's the faces of those on the bench, they're looking a little glum, aren't they, South Africa? And we know that Bongi Mosomi in particular, who plays in the Super League, was initially in the squad and then withdrawn, not exactly sure the reasons why, but replaced for this one. But they have got some young players, some new caps in their side as well, South Africa, and in their squad. But let's have a look at some of the goals we saw from that quarter. Bayman feeding into the circle, and Halsby. It looks like such an easy shooter
really
in the centre of her action.
Good high release shooting action. It's very difficult for a defender, even the most athletic, to get anywhere near to putting a tip to the ball when she's shooting.
And for South Africa, Holtzhausen, the skipper for the Proteas.
Again, really good action. Interesting, a left-hander shooter there. Most of us shoot with right hands, so makes the defence just think and go on court and make sure they've been aware of what type of shooters they're playing against.
Well, there are some more instructions being instructed to Tamsin Greenway, and a fairly animated Tracy Neville as well issuing her instructions, although I'm not sure Tracy Neville is ever anything but animated when she's down on the bench talking to her team. But she's probably making sure that they realise that an 18-goal margin, there's no time to sit back, keep at it, keep the pressure on, keep looking to improve and widen that gap.
Well, they'll be working, I would suspect, as you said earlier, on very specific goals for each quarter. So they'll be set very clear aims. It might be around the number of conversions of turnover, how many centre passes they've kept, the sort of sequencing or type of play, what defence they're doing. So I'm sure Tracy will be really clear what she wants from her team in the quarter. Looks like they may be keeping a very similar 7 again, so not running the changes this time, which is interesting.
Yeah, it is certainly Trinidad and Tobago in that first match today. I think they all 12 squad members used at some point in the match. So, had a good look at everyone, but then has seemingly settled for the moment on this, which is a strong-looking 7 from the squad that is here. Rachel Dunn is on the bench. Sam Cook is on the bench at the moment. Layla Guscott. But don't forget as well, there's a hashtag in the bottom right-hand corner of the screen. If you want to get in touch, hashtag Netball Europe. And at Netball Europe, you can certainly get in touch with us. Hampshire Netball, I've just seen, have tweeted, saying, Netball fans, one day nearly over, 3 more fantastic days ahead to enjoy. So make sure you do tune in and enjoy all of those. Michaela has said, need to be at the Antrim Forum right now, not revising. Well, make sure you don't fluff your exams. You don't want to be responsible for that, though. But, yeah, keep following the netball action. Have it on in the background. That's all right, isn't it?
I think there's a lot of people who I've been hearing from today saying, oh, I can't work because I want to watch the netball. And almost if it's a bad thing to have netball on all day. I can't think of anything better, personally.
Jem Hudson says, I love it when there's so much netters on. Hashtag netball geek. Hashtag netball Europe. You can be a geek around us. It's okay.
I had my first lesson in how to tweet this morning, so I'm now an expert.
Oh, I see. A Twitter novice.
I was, but
it won't take you long. It won't take you long. But loads have been pouring in all day. It's really great to see the communication and the netball community buzzing with this tournament happening here in Antrim. South Africa took a little bit longer to come back out on court for their customary huddle. And they've made a few changes to try and freshen things up. Goal shooter is Melissa Myberg. Van der Merwe coming in at wing defence. Fumza Mwaini of Loughborough Lightning coming in at goalkeeper. And Lauren Lee Christians at wing attack. So South Africa and their coach Benny Seaman hoping that those changes will affect two in attack and two in defence for South Africa, so changes across the court.
I think the netball obviously comfortable with their seven.
Yeah, and
no changes
really
again.
Cookie's starting to enjoy it when that smile starts to break out.
I think if I was a girl defender and Pamela Cookie was smiling, I'd be worried.
Should be.
Oh, called Cookie for 3 seconds there, the umpire. Goalkeeper, South Africa brought on. New tall player out there. Excellent shooting by South Africa there, goal attack.
How's we have both arms outstretched then? Saying, come on, give it to me. Again, great
ball.
Great move by Cookie.
That was really good positioning by Cookie there to get the rebound. She's not the tallest shooter, but
she makes up for it with athleticism.
She does indeed, and positioning, and use very good netball brain in Pamela.
Berger looking for her options, going for the long option. It's a good one as well because she's unmarked Holtzhausen.
Yeah, good screening in there by the South African shooters, created space for the goal attack there to be unmarked.
Melissa Myberg, the new goal shooter on court. Greenway, Housby. Oh, I just needed to be a fraction quicker, I think, Bayman. But Housby's got the opportunity now with the penalty pass or shots. Well, Mwaini has been subbed on as goalkeeper, doing a good job getting that rebound, but there's Cookie. Yep, might miss from there. No infringement on that goal third. Brings play forward up to the third line. Holtzhausen. Oh. Would have been a great effort if she got it in from there. And now it's Myberg in optimum shooting position.
First 2.5 minutes, it's pretty evenly balanced in this quarter. South Africa, some new combinations have come out a bit stronger than they finished the second.
Vicky again. Mwangi doing her best to lean in and defend. Pretty tough to defend against Pam Cookie's class and her consistency.
Yeah, when you look at the players that England have on the court now and the ones who've come back from injury and who are playing again at the top of their game, I think there's a lot of people who thought perhaps Stacey Francis, Pamela Cookie, with the injuries they had, wouldn't come back. So England netball certainly doing something really well in terms of rehabilitation of players at the right time, at the right pace.
That's Fumza Mwaini. Quite an extraordinary story in herself, coming over and playing for Loughborough Lightning. The first member of her family to travel abroad. She grew up in what is one of the largest townships just outside Cape Town in South Africa, the Cape Flats.
It's that point about netball being more than just a sport, isn't it? It gives people life opportunities, gives you life skills. I think that's just a huge example of it.
I think her father is being quoted as saying something very similar about the opportunities that it's afforded.
Oh, great. Turnover. Great work there by England netball. Good tip by Malcolm to McCloma.
Now, quick passage of play down court, but South Africa win it back. Here is Mwaini all the way down court to Myberg. Holtzhausen is battling to get free, which is being held up well by Stacey Francis. Now at the edge of the circle, Myberg's available.
South Africa just playing the ball around a little bit more. They're creating space in there, being a bit more patient in attack, but not the clinical finish that you'd have hoped for.
No. Oh, McCloma using all her heights.
McCloma's going to be all over that one.
Bayman, Greenway into Cookie.
That was really good timing all the way down the court. Surprised that we didn't have a shot there.
Now they should. Housby. A lovely split landing again. Just bring her closer to the post. Well, that was a gift.
There's only three goals in it this quarter so far, so South Africa making a better game of it.
Perhaps those changes have had good effect. Myberg finds the net. For England, 20 goals in front still. Bayman. Yeah. Thrown from the back line.
Yeah, I think they thought they might have got a bit of contact there, but the umpire saw the out of court. Great ball by Greenway. Good vision in there.
Have you ever seen Helen Housby unruffled? She seems the personification of calm
for somebody
beneath the post.
So young.
Holtzhausen, need to get the hurry on. Yep, the quick 1-2, getting herself into a better position.
Oh, but great tip by McCloma there. Good timing.
Okay, you're putting the pressure on. And suddenly it's hard work to get the ball back into the circle for South Africa.
There we are again.
Well, we've had a number of chances, South Africa, here in this little passage of play. And finally get that one. Still a 20 goal gap.
Oh, there you go. Look after the ball. Good turnover, and then straight away, gone the other way.
And a penalty parcel shot in the circle for Housby. Will she go from here? Yes, she will. Beautifully done. I like the fact that Housby isn't afraid to have a shot from
further out. Always looking at the post. So she gets the ball and she looks to shoot. And that's what a shooter should do. And it sounds really basic, but you'll look at some shooters and they won't turn fully and look at the post. They'll be sort of unsure, and that immediately gives the defenders confidence that the shooter isn't going to be putting up the ball. With Housby, you know that she could shoot from anywhere, and she will always look to the post.
Well, she's got herself in a great position, Myberg.
McComber and Frances are saying, was that me or was that you?
Laughing
a little bit
off.
Of a talking there going on, not quite sure. Maybe a little bit of misunderstanding there.
Vicky Housby, and getting that large stride meant that she took the ball quite near the edge of the circle. Was able to bring her in much closer. Didn't help with the shot on that occasion, but Cookie's going to have a second attempt. Berger again, centre for South Africa. Yeah, contact on McClomer. By McClomer, I should say.
Yeah, the speed with which England are still playing in this second game.
Still with intensity.
Yeah, absolutely, with real clear purpose.
And with such a lead. And Myberg, it's got itself into some good positions, Myberg, since coming on.
Yeah, she started, I think, the game earlier on for South Africa. They made a sub there, but obviously brought her back into this one. She's been quite effective so far this quarter.
Oh, rare miss by Cookie in the possession going back to South Africa.
Yeah, and in terms of the competitiveness of this quarter, England are only ahead by two at the moment. I think England will be disappointed that they haven't maintained their significantly than they did in the last two quarters.
Just a moment while the ball is retrieved. No contact again, Bayman.
Oh, just not quite weighted the right way, that ball. Right idea.
McClomer moving it out to Francis. Bayman has plenty of space in that midcourt. Here comes Mwaney, opting for the square pass option. We need to start moving this ball forward though, England. Keeping the pressure on in that goal third.
Interesting distance on that one.
And McClomer quite often opts to come in from sideways on, doesn't she?
Manages to put a lot of pressure on the ball with her positioning and timing.
Yep, chance for Holzhausen. Yep. Clean shots, a pleasing sight for the shooter when the ball goes through the ring cleanly.
Yeah, and then the lead's only one in this quarter, so interesting to see if England rein any changes.
Yeah, they've certainly been more challenged by South Africa now. Long ball into Housby.
But that transition from defence to attack for England netball is just amazing. They don't get it right every time, but when they do, South Africa have just got to get back a bit quicker. They've got to shut down those fast balls. They've got to put a little bit more pressure on the players bringing it through. It's just a little bit too easy for England sometimes.
And these two in the circle, Halsby and Cookie, really make it look easy. But that's netball at the highest level. Does look easy, doesn't it, when it's played well? Berger. Took too long.
Yeah, she did. I remember a very well-known, famous coach called Lynn Gunson telling us a number of years ago and how simple a game netball was. And all you had to do is get the ball to your players, to the shooters, and you'll win the game.
And just keep possession. Get it down there.
That's all. That's what Lynn used to say. It's a simple game.
Well, 24-46. In terms of the overall match, England have
just stepped it away in that last quarter. Those last few couple of minutes put a little bit of light between them and South Africa in this quarter. Again, with this South African side being young, you're wondering just how their legs are feeling and whether the two games today are beginning to show in their quality and their consistency.
Yep. Whoa, what a long ball. Seeing that the clock was ticking down.
That was good vision by Frances. She knew that there wasn't long, and she thought there was nothing to lose. Try to get the ball into the shooters.
Well, it's having that awareness, isn't it, as much as anything, knowing that the clock is ticking down and knowing what you've got to do. South Africa are trailing by a hefty margin. England 47-24 overall in the match. Do you think there may be some changes now then, Lynn, given that South Africa were closer to England in that quarter?
Well, it looks from the players on the England bench who are warming up, I think that might be the case. Now, whether that's because the quarter was closer or whether it was a planned change, I'm not too sure. They pulled away a little bit more in that last few minutes, England, but it wasn't the same performance in the first two quarters. And interestingly, it was the seven players on court. So putting a different combination out there from South Africa, you wonder where we would have been had they started with that seven. So there's certainly a learning point from their bench in to reflect on after the game.
And McLomone, how effective has she been as goalkeeper, even in that last quarter?
It's funny seeing McLomone back in an England red dress. It almost feels, in some way, she's never been away. It's been 4 years since Singapore and the last World Netball Cup, and you know, she's played through that 4 years. It's not as if she hasn't played completely. However, she hasn't played at this level yet. You know, she's slotted back in really well, and that leadership role she almost automatically assumes and brings to the team is really effective.
It's almost like having a second captain out there in all but names, with the presence that she's got and the way she commands that goal, defensive goal circle. But also, as I mentioned before, the vision she's got up the court to be able to have her input into passages of play.
Definitely. And you know, you've got two real strong, well, you've got a whole range of leaders on that court, to be honest, and Bayman as well. But if you look on the three areas of the court, you've got Cookie up there in the shooting end, you've got Bayman in the centre, and you've got McLomer at the back. And in terms of what that does for a team and that understanding cohesion at that senior player level, it adds a huge amount to what is already a very good performing match today for them.
And so much experience, Sonia McLomer. As for South Africa then, let's see if they can keep up the better performance for that third quarter. Can they carry that over into the fourth? They're being issued with some quite direct instructions by the look of it from Benny Simon, their coach.
It looks like we're going to see some changes from both sides here.
And here's some of the goals from that third quarter. And also McLomer's attempts at marking those attackers. So England have made some changes.
Yeah, we've got a change in the defensive end. So Leila Guscott's come on at goal defence, and Stacey Francis has moved up to wing defence. We've got Helen Hasby has put on the goal attack bib, and Rachel Dunn's come on at goal shooter. So some of the combinations that England will have played when the Trinidad and Tobago test series was on.
Fast work by South Africa. Ian Holtzhausen. really not looking at the goal when she first got that opportunity in the circle. She wasn't that much further out than where she took the shot from just then. Her first instinct was to try and get closer.
Yes, a lot of shooters do. I know, I put my hand up, I used to do that sometimes as well. And whether it's psychological, you've landed, you don't feel quite settled, you feel better passing it out and getting back in, so you are in the right frame of mind to shoot. I don't know, and there's a school of thought that says you get it in the circle, you should be able to turn and shoot from anywhere.
And when you were practicing your shooting, you were saying about the 200 odd goals that a shooter you're expected to practice on a daily basis. Would you practice a lot of those goals from the edge of the circle? I mean, if a shooter gets to the point where they can almost feel as comfortable shooting a such long distance shots, that would be an immense strength to have.
We probably would do it on a percentage, so you take, you know, maybe 50% of the shots from within the inner circle, because that's generally where you look, and maybe another 25, and then 25% on the actual outside of the ring. But it's more about the quality of the practice, and these players will be putting up real intense shots, so they'll be working hard before they put a shot up in the same way they would do on a court. Wouldn't be just stand and put up 200 shots. It's just not what they do when they actually work out here.
You've got to make it, try and replicate a match situation as much as you can.
Absolutely.
So.
Great interception by Housby there.
Yeah, wonderful stuff. That's the sort of advantage that she can give. 26 goals the difference. Myberg, good effort.
That was a good pass by Dunn, straight under the post to Housby.
Francis from the sideline to Bayman, straight into Dunn.
South Africa almost seem as just slightly off the pace at the moment. They're not quite as tight on the players on defensively. They're dropping off perhaps a little bit too much. Although that was a bit of an unforced error there by Greenway.
And could that be a fitness thing?
Well, I wouldn't put it down to that with Tamsin Greenway. She's played a whole season, you know, Super League, been really effective there. That was a really good interception by Guskoff there. Sometimes it's about seeing different players in front of you, not quite sure where everyone will be. I think everyone just makes the odd mistake.
No mistake from Myberg then.
It's interesting, when the South Africans turn around, all they see in between them and their players is a sea of red. So England Netball's positioning defensively.
He's closing down the options, aren't they?
Absolutely, and really trying to force a long overhead, which is going to give them opportunity for an intercept.
Yeah, particularly with the height of McCloma there in defence. Bayman out to Housby in a new position this quarter with goal attack. And Greenway playing through the full match here, as is Sarah Bayman. And we've got so many more matches still to go in this tournament as well. This is just the opening day.
Oh, great,
great work.
Fantastic. I mean, that's what Stacey Francis does so well, her commitment to an interception.
Nice work from Greenway, but overhead, not quite weighted well enough, but they should still be able to feed it into the circle from here. Oh, Housby, a rare fumble, but put under a bit of contact from behind. There's that long, tall reach of Housby again.
Yeah, Dunn and Housby have got a very good understanding in there. They're shooter-to-shooter balls working really well. Doesn't feel like they're under any particular pressure.
Stacey Francis was on the floor. She's got herself back up again. And for those players who have been, not sub, but moved around the courts, a chance for them to show...
Well, I think this is part
showing,
of...
Yeah, showing Tracy Noble they can play in more
exactly.
than one position.
Exactly. This is Tracy giving everyone an opportunity to say, well, I'm not just a show pony as such. You know, with 12 players, a number of games, one or two injuries, and then all of a sudden, you're running out of options if you have too many players who can only... offer you one position on court.
So when you're going away for the length of a World Cup, you can't afford to have an injury that then leaves you short. You've got to be able to have cover and effective cover.
Absolutely.
Like McLomer to move the ball away out of the goal third. Francis. Oh. Almost a collision between the two South African shooters then. Foxhausen finishing things off. And England making quick passage play down the court, but lose. No.
It's a contact called against
the
centre for South Africa. Good passing by Greenway.
Noemi making contact that time.
No shooters to be seen in the
yeah, really
South
having
Africa
to come out of position.
Circle there. They're really having to come deep to support their team, bring the ball down. So England defence is working really well.
Housby can get herself free in the circle. He opts to move out and...
Contact there by the goalkeeper. Umpire saying she's feeling for a player.
Done. Now Housby is looking for it. Good feed into Dunn.
Good patience by Bayman to spot the opening as Dunn cut back there under the post.
Holtzhausen. And they find Myberg in a good position here.
That was better by South Africa.
That's Nita. Oh, very quick feed from Greenway all the way down court to Dunn. Great from Housby. That long stride puts her in well within her range. What a fantastic game she's had. Yeah, Housby.
Still
really
looks
doing the business.
Cool as a cucumber
yeah,
out
barely
there.
Broken sweat. Despite the extra legwork she'll be putting in now in the goal attack position. Extra court coverage. Yep, possession to England. Came off one of the South African defenders.
Good sharp. Nice little pop ball to done under the post by Housby. They're just really pulling away now.
Yeah, they really are. 4 minutes to go. And plenty of time to add to their score quite substantially. And again, contact. I think Mawaney's been pulled up quite a few times in that goalkeeper role.
Yeah, if her coach is going to give her any feedback, it will be about that discipline, about 3 feet, not giving away endless penalties, just makes it a bit easier for their opposition in there. She seems a bit sort of flat on court.
Myberg will get another go here. Oh, great play.
That's great.
1, 2, 3 passes straight to the circle. Goal shooter and in.
I think the defensive working there between the back four for England is proving really effective. And there again is another turnover. And then the transition out of defence.
Bayman again looking for Housby. Managed to shake off her defender and get herself into the space for the high ball. Dunn's looking for somebody there in that circle. Oh, no, real giveaway that was.
Yeah.
Oh, great work, McCloma.
Reverse tip there by McCloma. The ball out. I've just got to not drop the quality here, make sure they're getting the ball uncontested to the players.
Lovely snatch there by Dunn as well. Clutching the ball in fast and firmly.
Again, that was exactly the same, really strong defensive work. It was McCloma who got the interception, but it was the pressure that the three players in front of her were putting on their players. That was a great spot. Well played, Bayman and Housby there.
Yeah, really a fantastic game today for Housby. He's got herself into good positions consistently. Well, 1 minute to go. England don't have possession. If they can get back possession, they might fancy getting that 70-goal mark in this match.
That was interesting. Stacey knew she'd contacted. The umpire wasn't sure. Stacey, the umpire didn't tell her to get back. All a little bit...
That was a brave effort by Holthausen.
Oh, a bit disappointed with that. Perhaps a little bit of lack of understanding about who was going to go for that one from McCloma between Descoth and Francis.
30 seconds left for England to make it 69. With more urgency in the play from England now, knowing that clock is running down on them. Looking to add to their score, and Dunn can do it now.
That was a great decision by Dunn. Drive to the post, just step back, makes her completely free, and then the ball came under the post. The timing was really good.
Can South Africa grab one back before the end of the match? And that goal won't stand at the end. But England, they have comprehensively beaten South Africa 69-33, an emphatic victory over a side ranked 3 places below them in the world. England showing that even with the squad of players here, let alone those who are coming back from the ANZ, they've got a terrific crop of players. And Helen Housby, their goal attack for England. Well, Lynn Carpenter, I mean, she had a great game, didn't she?
She did, and Housby's showing that she's versatile, both goal shooter and goal attack. For a tall shooter, she is a really strong goal attack, reads the game well, rotates and creates space in the circle. And I think it's her shooting is just so calm and collected. And that, as I said earlier, is actually something that gives the rest of the team a huge amount of confidence. To know that your shooters are going to score, have a real high expectation, just gives you that much confidence in the rest of the play.
I mean, she's only 20 years old and so new into this England side, but she's really holding her hand up to say, look, Tracy Neville, look what I can do for you. I could play in a World Cup.
And why wouldn't you? You know, people probably said a few months ago you could name the shooters from England who would be going to the World Netball Cup, but there's a real competition there on the hands, and Tracy's going to have some real good, strong choices in terms of that. So, you know, if Jo Harton is in New Zealand watching this, she'll know that she's got competition. She plays fantastically. She's had a great season. But you've got players here who are saying, you know, I want to go to Sydney. So it's interesting.
Well, let's have a few look at some of the goals from this England-South Africa match and also some of the defence. But Holtzhausen for South Africa and familiar to Super League viewers. Her time there, but here is Housby in that lovely high shooting action and shows so little reaction as well, whether the goal goes in or misses. Her demeanor stays exactly the same.
She reminds me a bit of Borg. People remember Bjorn Borg as a tennis player. He was always a real favorite of mine because it didn't matter what was going on. You never knew what was kind of going through his head until the last minute when he won match point. And to some extent it's a little bit with Helen here, you wouldn't really know what was going through her mind. She's just quietly effective all the time.
Is she feeling stressed? Is she feeling confident? Is she feeling jubilant? Is she frustrated? And that for an opponent never gives them a chink.
No, definitely not.
Well, what a day it has been here then. Day one of the Netball Europe Open Championships. We have had 6 matches, wins for Ireland, England twice, for South Africa over Scotland, a draw, a dramatic draw between Wales and Northern Ireland. Malta and Switzerland, well, they played earlier today. They play again tomorrow, and they're the first match of the day at 8:30 in the morning. Remember that their matches will be on demand. Today's matches are all available, will all be available on demand for you. So you will be able to watch those again from tomorrow. So do join us then. We will be on air just before 8:30, just before the start of the Switzerland-Malta match. All the teams play again tomorrow. England are up against Scotland, so they'll be back on again at 4:30 tomorrow afternoon. My thanks to Lynn Carpenter, Chair of Netball Europe, who's been with us today, and all our other summarisers. And thank you very much to you for your company as well. England victorious against South Africa, 69-33. We look forward to seeing you tomorrow.